Thank you so much, Shannon. They can invite her back to sing anytime. Just fantastic. Chance for the Islanders to get above 500 for the first time this season, and they will go back to Thomas Greiss, who had a strong performance in the win on Sunday against Minnesota. You see his record on the season. He stopped 26 of 29 in a 6-3 victory on Sunday. First time he's getting a chance to start back-to-back games, albeit not on back-to-back days. For the Montreal Canadiens, a familiar face in Al Montoya. He's been the backup to Roberto Luongo in Florida the past couple of years, put some outstanding numbers together last season with a 2.18 goals against average, and this year off the charts, filling in for an ill Carey Price for the first three games of the season.
Well, he's done a terrific job as a backup goaltender with a number of teams, with the Winnipeg Jets. He was with the Islanders at one point in time. He's a former number one pick for the New York Rangers. So Al is a survivor, and wherever your position you put him in, he seems to do extremely well. He'll have fun playing against his former teammates tonight.
Sixth overall pick back in 2004. One lineup change today, and that is the teenager. Matthew Barzell will make his second NHL appearance, but Nikolai Kuhlman on the flip side of that is missing his first game in a long time for the New York Islanders.
Now they'll miss Kuhlman, but I'm excited to watch Barzell. I'm a big fan of his. He's a very gifted individual, great skater, very creative. He'll make things happen on the offensive side. He's still learning about the defensive side, and that's the only thing that's holding him back a little bit now. But I'm excited for this guy. Beauvillier has proven he can play in the National Hockey League, and Matthew Barzell will want to do the exact same thing.
Barzell played in just the second game of the season. That was in Washington against the Capitals. Of course, had the unfortunate circumstance of 6 penalty minutes in that game, including back-to-back minors, without actually stepping out of the penalty box. And we'll see how the first period rolls along for him. There was a momentary delay.
Do you think the coach held that against him?
I don't think so.
Nope. Actually, everybody was laughing about that sequence, and albeit it wasn't funny at the time, but you know what? Everybody has different first games.
Yep.
Matthew had certainly a very unique first
he's
game.
He's got a good story.
Yeah,
he's got a good story out of it, one way or the other. Off the opening faceoff, Clutterbuck will swing it around the net, and we are underway here at Barclays Center. It is Jason Chimera who shifts into the role of Nikolai Kuhlman to play along with Cizikas and Clutterbuck, a role that many thought he would have started the season in when he was picked up during the offseason from the Washington Capitals. Seidenberg and DeHaan playing together as well. Starting lineups are brought to you by Infinity. And with the changing of line mates all over the ice, we'll see some more ice time for Anthony Beauvillier, you would expect, as he moves up to play with Nelson and Lee. And you're also going to see Ryan Strome shift back from center to wing. Tavares to the outside, had it poked off his stick. Surveys the scene and throws it wide of the net. Andrew Ladd after it. Shaw got there first, and it's punched back out to center for Letty.
Now, the way the Strome line's been playing, I'm not sure that's moving up.
This is a good point. They were so good together. His Ladd shot, big rebound to Tavares. A tip from a Letty shot wouldn't go. Tavares behind the net again, looking towards the line. Got double team there. The puck popped free, and here come the Canadiens, 3-on-1. Lekkonen, he's got Radulov across, played perfectly by Letty. Not a shot taken on the play. Picked up though by Plekanec, and he shoves one, trying to go short side. And hugging that post was Thomas Greiss. Plekanec again behind the net for Radulov. Letty skates in the way. Bailey will sweep the puck and take it off towards the boards. And now he took too long with it. Letty and Radulov come together along the end wall. Letty can't work it past Markov, but Tavares Kent cutting back, buying some time. End of a long shift for that line. As Anders Lee is fresh out onto the ice, banging his stick, looking for the puck. They couldn't get it to him until now.
Letty acting like a quarterback that couldn't find that receiver and wanted to make sure it wasn't going to be intercepted.
Beauvillier puts it behind the goal line. Lee is after it. Will take the body on Nathan Beaulieu. And now Nelson trying to catch up to Max Pacioretty, the captain for the Montreal Canadiens, who are off to a 5-0-1 start. The last team in the National Hockey League to have yet to lose in regulation. Shootout loss is their only blemish.
Let's remember, they started awful well last year, and then they ran into the injury with their goaltender. So I don't think they're celebrating quite yet with the start, but I know the coach is happy.
Here's Nelson off a feed from Beauvillier, and he got handcuffed with Pacioretty there. Take it away, Alex Galchenyuk to Beaulieu, and he'll hammer it in. Greiss a standing stop. Gallagher was pressuring, and Greiss played it anyway, and it nearly created an opportunity for Torrey Mitchell streaking in. Now it's Matthew Barzell. He'll lead the charge up ice for the Islanders. Barzell to the outside on Weber. The backhand deflected off the backboards. Near side wall. Alexei Yemelin cleared it as far as center. Seidenberg back to Barzal. And then DeHaan once again. Tried to force a pass, and it nearly cut off by Mitchell. Barzal to Quine, and Quine is injured, not putting any pressure on that left leg as he limps off the ice. Boy, not what you want to see, and that happened away from the puck as well as Quine getting some attention on the bench from the athletic training staff.
First shift, so Jack Capuano may be forced to juggle his lines if Quine is hurt any more seriously than it looked.
Down deep, Andrew Shaw. Shaw behind the net, rimmed all the way around Nathan Beaulieu. Back to Shaw in his skates. Ezekis on him. Laid behind the net. David Desharnais. As Shaw to the slot, tried to get it there. A skate in the way. Clutterbuck had his pocket picked from behind by Byron. Seidenberg trying to get it from Shaw. Bouncing a puck in the slot. Shaw turned it towards the net. Never made it on goal. Clutterbuck loses an edge. And the puck comes to Markov. And Seidenberg stepped in front of that shot.
Shaw from Chicago signed a 6-year deal, I believe it was, for a lot of money.
6 years. $23.4 million.
Can live on that.
Yep. Qualifies as a lot of money. They just didn't have it in the budget in Chicago. It was a restricted free agent and just couldn't get a deal done that made sense with their salary cap. And so he winds up here in a Montreal Canadiens uniform.
Well, let's take another look at the Quine incident. There he is along the boards. Looks like it's just a little bit of a collision with Emelin. And then Letty. Letty's 3-on-1. You got to try and make a decision so your goaltender can react. And Letty times it perfect on the forward. Lehtinen. You can see the spreading out and the use of the stick by Nick Letty. It's good to be 6'2". Just that extra couple inches was very valuable in making that defensive play on Lehtinen.
Showed you a quick shot there of Alan Quine, who is still on the bench and appears to be no longer the focus of the athletic training staff on that bench. So we'll keep an eye and see if he comes out for his next shift. Kyle Clutterbuck got his skate worked on after blowing a tire on his last shift as well, as John Tavares will backhand this one in the direction of Andrew Ladd.
A lot of injuries. It's like a stinger. It hurts just for a little bit, and then once you have a chance to take a deep breath, it's not as bad as you thought it might be.
Boychuk trying to keep the puck in. Lehtinen will rip it across the ice and let Radulov skate into it. Alexander Radulov dropped it off, and that one came to Ladd instead. And then Brock Nelson trying to maneuver past Beaulieu, couldn't get there. Pacioretty will hand it back, and Beaulieu and Pacioretty working on Beauvillier. Across the ice for Shea Weber as Beauvillier lost his stick, will go to the bench for a change instead of a new one as Ryan Strome will take his place. Anders Lee chipped ahead, sending Strome after. Scored a goal over the weekend. Strome has a couple. The scoring has been spread out for the New York Islanders. Not so much here for a lot of other teams like the Montreal Canadiens. Brendan Gallagher has 4 goals. John Tavares did get his 2nd and 3rd on Sunday, but lots of different players in the defense, a big part of that, stepping in with some offense as Strome opens up. Had an option to go to Letty, dragged it behind the net instead. Strome and Pacioretty come together along the boards, but Greg Patterson will stop behind Al Montoya.
Strome not worried about whether he plays center or wing. He told me this today with the bench hit. That ice time, that's all he cares about, which makes a lot of sense. Doesn't matter what position, just get me on the ice, coach.
He does shift back to wing as Kuhlman, a winger, is out. And Barzal, who they have made perfectly clear they are only comfortable with him playing the center position, comes into the lineup to take that spot. If Shane Prince were healthy and activated from the IR, they could have done some different things. But really, the only option for Jack Capuano is to use the versatility of Ryan Strome. Stretch pass ahead for Philip Deneau. And then off the stick of DeHaan. This one's behind Thomas Greiss. Shots through all of this, and we are approaching 6.5 minutes into the period, are 1-1. As Ezekis, the Seidenberg, didn't get a lot of that pass, and it's cut off instead by Brian Flynn. This one's going up over the glass and out of play. 13-20, 3 to go. Nothing going so far here in Brooklyn.
Thank you.
No score here in Brooklyn, and you could win a pair of Islanders tickets and a Josh Bailey signed puck in the WBAB Islanders Player to Watch sweepstakes. Listen to Roger and JP on WBAB 102.3 tomorrow morning at 8:50 a.m. and call in for your chance to win. Remember, the WBAB Islanders Player to Watch tonight is Anthony Beauvillier, who is taking on a team that he grew up watching.
Absolutely. I mean, imagine as a kid, right, all three of your teams, you're watching the Montreal Canadiens, and a big moment for him is he gets a chance to play against one of his favorite players, and young Mr. Gallagher. Well, no wonder why. I mean, they both play a very similar game.
Gallagher just in his fourth season in the National Hockey League, but that gives you an idea of how young Anthony Beauvillier is, because when Brendan Gallagher 4 years ago broke in, he was just a 14-year-old kid.
Yes, exactly right. And I mean, you know, when you're in Montreal, hockey is everything during the winter, so that's what you do. You watch the Montreal Canadiens.
Chimera got it from Letty. Letty will shoot it. Never quite made it through. And then Letty able to jump and keep it in. What a hold for Nick Letty. But he fooled his teammates as everybody just gave up and went to the bench thinking that thing was down the ice.
A tremendous play, tremendous skill play. And obviously Letty could play a little basketball because he went way up in the air and one-handed it, made a spinorama move, and then dropped it down. The Canadians were quick to react. The Islanders were going on the way out, playing a little bit defense. Look how high up he is. He jumps way up there. He's got the puck and drops it down neatly. Players couldn't quite react. They couldn't anticipate that play. Well, he's got a new skill that we didn't know about.
Trying to work that into the playbook. Here's Letty jamming it through the top of the crease. And Tavares to track it down. Hamonic's quick shot snuck in there on Montoya as he clutches for the whistle.
Andrew Ladd right in the high slot area. Tried to follow it. Little deflection. Well, he badly needs a goal. I mean, this is a guy that plays hard shift after shift. Like I said before, he's a straight ahead player. Goes to net just looking for that opportunity to somehow get off the zeros. He's got one assist, but he was in good position. And if you get enough opportunities, they'll go in.
We've talked about this before, but Jack Capuano said you worry about guys when they're not creating chances, and Ladd might not be finishing them at this point, but the chances have been there for Ladd and his linemates. Radulov trying to dance in, and DeHaan having none of that.
He continues to play with Tavares. He's going to get plenty.
Up along the boards, Lekin canceled out by Seidenberg. Yemelin able to pull it away from Andrew Ladd. But it's given back to Ladd. Tried to touch it to Tavares. It went askew. Seidenberg followed it up. And then as that pinballed around, Plekanec settles it down. Shea Weber nearly lost it to Ladd closing in.
Game of ping pong in the neutral zone.
Seidenberg will leave it behind for DeHaan, who collects it with his skinks and spins to try and get away from Lekkonen. Additional pressure coming from Desharnais, and the pass goes between the two defensemen for the Canadiens and down the ice to Al Montoya.
Both teams very, very good in the defensive zone. Jack Capuano spending a lot more time in practice in the D zone, 5-on-5.
Here's Nelson, wraparound try, and there was Montoya. And this offensive chance set up by a hit on good pressure from Anthony Beauvillier as the puck jumps into the front row.
Good speed by Brock Nelson as he's able to keep his feet moving, trying to use his long reach to go to the far side. He knows Montoya is going to take away the post, so Brock Nelson says, let me see if I can go five holes, see if Montoya is covering that area. Good hard play by Beauvillier. Not only is he a smart hockey player, makes good passes, but he finishes his check, so this is a guy that's becoming a two-way hockey player in every sense in the National Hockey League.
We talked about the adjustment. Is he's a natural center as well. He rips his shot wide of the net, and Hickey will come to it on the boards. That one hit a body in front as it continues to work around the boards and now carried through center and dumped down by the Canadiens.
Well, Canada did pretty well with all the sentiment on their team. That's the smart part of the team.
Beaulieu in on goal, and it's covered up by Thomas Greiss. There was no personal thing there, I'm sure. It's time now for the Tin Cup Mountain Whiskey Play for the Cup rankings. As we've talked about it already, the great start for the Canadiens this season, but last season, an even better start, and they're hoping history doesn't repeat itself. If Carey Price goes down, they're hoping Al Montoya can pick up the slack a little better than Mike Condon and company was able to do a year ago.
Well, Coach Therrien was talking about the importance of Carey Price. What a leader he is in the dressing room, the presence, the timely saves, the best goaltender in the world. And thus the team just was never able to get its footing after Carey Price went down. He couldn't say enough good things about Carey Price and what he means to the organization.
Mike Condon was in the organization during training camp, but he was beaten out for the backup job by Montoya, placed on waivers with the intention of heading to St. John's in the American Hockey League. However, he was claimed. by somebody that we will see tomorrow, the Pittsburgh Penguins. Although with Matt Murray returning, you wonder how many days left on the roster there are for Mike Condon in Pittsburgh.
Probably end up in the minors if someone else doesn't claim him.
Or Los Angeles.
Yeah. LA or Boston. Boston looking for a goaltender.
Very true.
Perhaps Gar Snow is in conversations with both of those teams since he has the luxury of having three goaltenders that can play in the National Hockey League.
J.F. Berube is backing up tonight. Thomas Greiss getting the start as Matthew Barzal just couldn't get that one to stick on his stick. And now Quine gives it up and back the other way. It is Gallagher in the slot and a blocker save by Thomas Greiss. The rebound clears the zone.
Transition very, very quick for the Montreal Canadiens. They're a little bit of a faster team this year. Galchenyuk now full-time centerman. 19 goals last year. Big season. His coach says he's still learning the game.
Icing call here against the Canadiens. Faceoff coming back towards Al Montoya. But shifting to a number one center is a big thing.
Well, you can see Gallagher waiting and waiting, and a nice pass. Thomas Greiss right in the middle of the net. He knows the pass is coming back into the slot area. Islanders with back pressure, but good save, good positioning by Greiss. There's Carey Price saying, well, I'll take the night off. It's okay. I'm going to play tomorrow. He's very calm, cool, doesn't waste a lot of energy even when he's not playing.
Canadians are back at home tomorrow night taking on the Tampa Bay Lightning. Another icing call here against Montreal. And then they've got Toronto on Saturday also at home.
Yeah, Coach Therrien was talking about Galchenyuk and I asked him, how is the kid doing now at center ice? He said, hey, listen, he's a real good hockey player and we went real slow with him. But he's still learning now to, you know, play in his own zone a little bit more. But more importantly, he's having to play against the number one defensive pairings, checkers, something you don't do when you're the number two center or the number two winger. So it's a little bit different challenge for him, but he likes the way he's handling it.
They moved him to center for the tail end of last season. He scored a whole bunch of goals as he had 16 goals in the final 22 games of the season. But one thing he is really struggling on this year in transitioning back to center is the faceoffs. As Letty walks right in and wires one into the catching mitt of Al Montoya. Pretty good chance as Letty took it from one end to the other, but Al Montoya keeps us scoreless. Islanders and Canadians scoreless here in the first. Friends, family, and co-workers can all be all four Islanders with group tickets. Get together with your fellow fans and make the night extra special with one of our fan experience packages. Make your group reservation before October 31st and save 30%. Call 844-ILS-GP or visit islanders.nhl.com/groups today. Getting every last drop here in Brooklyn before the team heads on the road to Pittsburgh tomorrow night.
Enjoying themselves, and that's what should happen when you come to a hockey game. You should enjoy yourself. You should have some fun.
Having a good time so far tonight. Shots on goal, 4 for the Islanders, the fourth just coming before the break. 3 for the Canadiens. Really no glorious scoring chances on either end. Just a stalemate so far in the early stages of this hockey game. Just over 9 minutes remaining in the first. Baylor tries to come out of the corner. Tavares was in front, but the pass shut down on his way there. Sent ahead and Lehkonen stepped around side and hurt, but Dahan a big lead on that race, but met quickly by Lehkonen, allows Tavares to get the puck. As Tavares swings it ahead for Bailey. Bailey tried to look back to Ladd, couldn't get the timing right. Tavares nearly picked up that ricochet off the corner boards. And now as it's back out at center ice, Seidenberg handles there. Lehkonen will bounce it down. Greiss behind the net to Blade as the Islanders switch their offensive unit with everybody except the right wing far change this period in Josh Bailey.
That was a nice play by Josh Bailey using the corner to carry him that puck right back into the slot. Don Tavares couldn't quite time it coming through the middle hard. Able to pick that one up.
Here's Beauvillier looking over and off the bench. It was Hickey trying to jump up, and there we see the defense joining the rush again as Brock Nelson trying to leave it behind for Beauvillier. It's in the skates of Nelson. Beauvillier trying to dig it out, but he has company in Alexei Yemelin.
And we haven't seen as much as the defense up on the play in this first period. And a lot of it has to do with that good first pass. Montreal Canadiens with a lot of pressure on the Islanders, so they haven't been able to make that good first pass and allow their defense to join the rush.
Islanders with multiple goals from defensemen in back-to-back games, and Boychuk has goals in both of the last two games. Fired wide there. Montoya made a couple of saves. The rebound was loose enough for Beauvillier to get an additional try as Montoya finally draws the whistle.
Good smart play by Thomas Hickey as he was over on the boards and just got the puck towards the net. The first one, I'm not sure Montoya saw it. It's just what they call a positional save. It's not a hard shot as we follow all the way to the net. No deflection, but you can see Montoya was down already. And then Lee with the rebound. Nelson stays with it. Beauvillier stays with it and whack it away. Montoya doesn't want to move because he's not sure where it is. He knows he's got the bottom of the net covered with the flippers.
So it remains scoreless as the puck inside the Canadian zone. Philip Dano got it out. Hickey will crank it right back in. Islanders touch up, and Tavares is after it. Forcing some pressure. Foley around the net. Pattern steered it by. Flynn coughed it up. Tavares tried to jump through to the front of the net.
Dano, a former first-round pick of the Chicago Blackhawks.
Came over in a trade last February.
And more of a grinder-type player, not what you would call a gifted offensive guy. These guys are all gifted, don't get me wrong. They're all very good hockey players, but some guys, you look for more goals. This is a player that I don't think you're looking for a lot of goals, just good hard work.
Just 4 goals in 51 games last year combined between Chicago and Montreal.
Well, every player makes a part of the team.
Brock Nelson had it for a moment, got it to Letty, and then behind the net for Anthony Beauvillier. Beauvillier on the backhand, Hadley couldn't get there. Now along the boards, Letty will step up and try and keep the play alive, and does for New York. Pushed around the net, racing to it, it's Andre Markov. Markov to Gallagher, couple of Canadians collide, and the pass from Beauvillier just out of the reach of Chimera, but here is Hezekas walking in from an angle, and there's a save from Montoya.
Islanders starting to take a little bit of the control of this first period, spending more time in the offensive zone. And the worst type of collisions is when you're not expecting it. Gallagher down low and runs right into Galchenyuk. Don't know who got the worst of it, but those type of hits are often more serious, more dangerous than any one hit that you sort of expect to come because you can prepare yourself. But both guys seem to be okay, thank goodness. Don't want to see anybody get hurt.
Gallagher got hurt last year in the final meeting with the Islanders as that one steered aside by Montoya. Missed 17 games after a hand injury.
Still managed to score 19 goals during the season, so, and he led his team on the plus minus, which is always a good number as far as I'm concerned, plus 13.
And he's off to it again, a plus 5 so far in the first 6 games of the season for Brendan Gallagher. As Jason Chimera tracks down a loose puck, gets it to Clutterbuck. Clutterbuck thought that Hamonic was there. Hamonic was on his way for a change. DeHaan had to wait on the bench to time that one well and just got it away before Radulov came. Hezekas dropped the side of Bert. Poke checked by Byron, overskated by DeArne, and that'll help out the Islanders as there were numbers favoring the guys in white. Clutterbuck staples Yemelin. And now Byron's pass at the skates of Barzell.
That's one guy you want to hit because he's going to get his licks in during the game, so you might as well get yours early. Lemonen is a good hockey player, but a very feisty individual.
We get a whistle here on a high stick, not a penalty, just an infraction and a faceoff coming when we come back. 5:23 to go in the first. We're scoreless.
Scoreless game between the Islanders and the Montreal Canadiens. Rick DiPietro, what defenseman for the Islanders is jumping out to you right now?
Nick Liddy's been unbelievable. I mean, if you're a kid watching at home, this is how you play defense in the National Hockey League. He's a goalie's best friend.
Well, we're going to have more on Nick Liddy with Rick DiPietro coming up in the Ford Intermission Report. We'll also have an Islanders player interview as well, but still about 5:23 to play here in the first, guys. Back up to you.
Well, the Islanders overall, yeah, thanks, Shannon. Well, the Islanders overall have played very good defense. Letty doing what he does best, using his skating.
Little tangle in front as Hezekas has his stick launched in the skate of Brendan Gallagher. They finally get separated, but Gallagher was able to get a shot towards the net when that puck came to him while Hezekas was trying to pull his stick out of his skate. As Weber, the wrist shot this time, stopped in front. And the puck worked behind the net, and Letty is after it.
Weber with the big shot didn't need to use it, just used his wrist shot to get it on net.
Hezekas was able to line up Alex Galchenyuk. That shot never made it on target. And now it's Chimera rushing up ice, lost it at the blue line. Pacioretty back in for the Habs. Gallagher Gallagher across the ice. Galchenyuk curling with it, looking to Beaulieu. Beaulieu straight away moves towards the boards. Into the circle, Beaulieu across for Weber. One-timer sailed on it. Not the big one there, but still dangerous enough. Just way off the mark.
Chimera turned that puck over in the neutral zone. That's something that, you know, playing with the Cizikas line, you just can't do. Your job is to make sure that you get the puck in deep, especially against the number one line for the Montreal Canadiens. Chimera still in the offensive mode from playing with Tavares.
Boychuk takes it off the back of the net, but gives it up here and coming in from the line. A shot that goes well wide, and then this one lifted by Lee. Punched back down at center by Jeff Petrie. Banged in on goal, so there is no icing. Greiss left it there for a moment. Hickey nearly beaten there by Mitchell. Beauvillier gets involved. Puck comes to Boychuk, looking for a way out. He'll go off the boards, out to center. Lee couldn't get his stick free, finally does, and swats it in with one hand. Up the wall in the skates of the referee. Beauvillier came to it. Torrey Mitchell was there as well. Bouncing out to the center circle. Boychuk to Hickey and back again. Boychuk will crank it in. Islanders get a fresh line out there. Alan Quine looks like he hasn't lost a step. That big shaken up early in this first period. Seidenberg trying to keep the line. Plekanec followed it up. Quine caught up to him and angled Plekanec off, allowing Seidenberg a little bit more space. But then Quine run off by Lekanec. And then at the right point, handing back off. Plekanec down low, touch to the slot, and that one off the skates of Greg Patterson. Loose puck in the Islanders' corner, stumbling is DeHaan, still able to get there first. Chips one in the air, Patterson will glove it down and give it right back to DeHaan. Inside the final 3 minutes of the first period, scoreless between the Islanders and the Montreal Canadiens. Islanders trying to win their third in a row. The Canadiens trying to win their fifth in a row. As Beaulieu puts it on goal and covered up by Greiss.
End to end for Beaulieu from the Montreal Canadian defenseman, not really known for his offense. He's able to penetrate inside the offensive zone, get the shot on net. Thomas Greiss was able to control it. Well, the good speed through the neutral zone, has his head up. The Islanders keep him to the outside, and there's the quick little wrist shot that Thomas Greiss is able to handle and smother rather quickly.
Shots on goal, 8-6 for the Islanders.
Very defensive-minded period for both teams, as you mentioned earlier, Brendan. No real great scoring opportunities.
Hamonic trying to get the puck back from DeArne, playing without his right glove, but plays as if he was well protected with both hands, as Yemelin across and then right to the front. Tavares won't let that shot get through. And then Tavares gave it up to Andrew Shaw, took it back, couldn't drag it around him. Now Letty and DeArne get together. Hamonic comes back behind the net to punch it away from Shaw. Letty, quick pass to Tavares. It's knocked off his stick, but he catches back up to it, and he'll make good on the clear.
I've always wondered how guys drop their gloves. I don't remember ever losing a glove. I didn't drop them, so I don't remember ever losing one when I was battling for the puck.
Those things were glued on.
Oh, boy.
Here comes Lee. Wrist shot. Montoya watches it sail by. Along the wall, Bailey and Pacioretty. It slips past both of them and Galchenyuk the other way. Gallagher tried to go back to Galchenyuk, and Lee had already knocked him down. Thomas Hickey. 90 seconds to go here in the first period. Anders Lee tries to walk past Petrie. Sticks came up. Puck rolled away and then fired off the glass and passed Pacioretty down the ice.
Both of these teams have had trouble making good first passes. A lot of pucks in the feed area along the boards, and that's why you're not seeing a lot of good scoring opportunities. It's like a battle. Each and every time the players have the puck. Look at Brock Nelson. You know, I want to get back to that. You know, we're talking about losing your gloves. Saw a picture today on Twitter of a jersey of mine, an original jersey, and it had a strap on the back, and the comment was, did he ever need one? And the answer to that is no, I did not need one. I wasn't going to be fighting anybody. I had Clark Gillies and Bobby Nystrom and Dwayne Sutter to do battle. So, no, that strap, I used to cut it when I got my jerseys.
No need for that. No.
I didn't want to see where those punches were coming from if someone grabbed me.
Nope, not at all. Just hiding here for a little bit. Dano wide of Thomas Greiss. Here with 1 minute to play in the first period.
Seidenberg lost the stick, now he's able to retrieve it.
Quine retrieves the puck, forced it ahead for Barzal, came back for Quine. And then Quine will lay it softly into the zone, and Strome and Quine will go to the bench for a change. Seidenberg trying to keep it. Instead, Dano punched it out, and here's Radulov. Radulov into the circle, left it in the slot, came back to Radulov. Poke check by Clutterbuck, continues on it. Radulov stopped him from heading up ice, but it's returned to Chimera, and Chimera digging forward in front of the benches. It squirts back here to the near boards. Dumped in with 22 seconds to go and covered up in the crease. But they, I believe, said this one came from the wrong side of the red line, and it'll be an icing call and a face-off back inside the Islanders. And
Radulov, a heck of a hockey player. He's now 30 years old. He had some issues with Nashville. But originally it was a high draft pick. And, I mean, this guy set all kinds of record in junior hockey. He was a Memorial Cup winner. He three-time champion in the KHL, scoring leader in at least three times. It was on a 50-game point streak with the Quebec Ramparts. Only Mario Lemieux had more. So this guy is an awful skilled guy. Hopefully he's matured a little and can settle in and have a good career.
He's physical as well, as Travis Hamonic just found out here in the closing seconds of the period, as Cizikas will try one last rush for the Islanders. Casey Cizikas dragged it in, but offsides will be called here if the Islanders do touch it. Time running down. Chimera will watch it instead of touching it and get us to the intermission in a scoreless tie. Shots on goal, 8 for the Islanders, 6 for the Canadiens.
Well, it was a period dominated by good defense on both sides of the puck. I mean, the Islanders, I thought, skated really well and played solid in their own zone, as did the Montreal Canadiens. So both goaltenders weren't tested severely. There was a couple of pretty good saves, but overall, it was the defensive side of the puck that everybody played well. Let's see if it continues that way. I know the coaches are always happy when there's good defense, but you and I, the fans, want to see good offense.
A little too much of that feeling out process in the first of three meetings. Stay tuned for the first period intermission report presented by Ford. Nick Leddy will join Shannon Hogan, and Rick DiPietro is aboard to break down the first period from tonight.
Tremendous recognition for Bill, and yes, the bow tie was his signature. It was a pleasure working for him, and that was a wonderful night for Bill.
Bill hanging here. They've got him hanging at the practice facility as well, and he is never far from the minds of Islanders players, coaches, and staff, the fans here as well.
The architect, that's a perfect name, because he certainly put together that Islander team. Took a few years for them to really get the engines rolling, but when we did, because I can say we,
yep, you can,
pretty much unstoppable.
You came in and just turned the engine over, just that last little piece.
I turned it in from maybe from a Ford to a Ferrari.
Something like that. Underway in the second period. Who's going to jump on the board first? The Islanders start Chimera, Cizikas, and Clutterbuck, as Nikolai Kuhlman missing tonight's game with an upper body injury. He is listed as day-to-day, injured in Sunday's game against Minnesota. Tried to practice yesterday. He didn't finish practice. Skated on his own today. And I guess we hold out hope that tomorrow is another day when the Islanders are in Pittsburgh to take on the Penguins.
Well, he's a tough guy. He doesn't miss a lot of hockey games, so you know that he's... Well, that was a legit injury.
Only sat out one game last year. That was the second to last game of the season where they rested him before the playoffs began. It was not an injury-related thing. This is the first time he's missed a game with the Islanders because of injury.
That leads me to believe that he may not play tomorrow, because it's not just a little owie.
Ladd across the ice for DeHaan. As DeHaan put that one up over the glass as he was on his way off the ice.
Actually deflected by Mitchell, got his stick in that, I would say it was a shooting lane, Brendan, but it was maybe the dumping lane.
We just did see DeHaan, though, take a shift with Nick Leddy. We'll keep an eye on the defense pairings as we move forward. It had been pretty much exclusively Leddy and Hamonic during that first period.
That might have been just a difficult change for the Islander defense. Sometimes that happens. One guy gets his stay is extended.
Out of the line, it's kept down into the corner now, right in front, and Hickey tied up Mitchell.
Great job of defense by Thomas Hickey, making sure, being strong on the stick and not allowing Mitchell to play that puck as it came through the crease.
Tavares shoveled one to the center circle, picked off by Flynn and rolled in, left at the side by Grice. Boychuk to Hickey, and Hickey cross ice pass to Bailey. It went by him, but came to Lee. Bailey heads to the goal, but Lee lost the puck. Taking a quick path around the back of the net. Patterns pass connects with Pacioretty. Pacioretty from the right side. Off the glass behind Thomas Greiss. Beauvillier's pass connects with Nelson. Brock Nelson with speed. Crisscrossing with Lee. Nelson back across the body of Montoya, but wide.
They had him beat too. Montoya's glove was down low. Brock Nelson was trying to go up high on the glove side. Just tried to be a little bit too fine with it.
Beauvillier and Shaw came together. Shaw gave him a couple extra whacks. It is Letty and Hamonic back together here on this defensive shift for Jack Capuano as David Desharnais tied up with Brock Nelson. Beauvillier came over, but it's held in at the point and then slid back down low for Desharnais. Shovels it over and broken up by Hamonic. He'll lead it ahead for Anders Lee. Lee waits, delays, and then puts it down behind the net, catches back up to it himself as he got locked up with Patterin. Barzell came over as he jams at the skates of Pacioretty. They gave it to Barzell. Collision there. Puck kept in by Hamonic, over for Letty. Letty to Barzell, and it jumped over his stick and came back out to center. A couple of turns later, Barzell looking for some space. His pass stolen away by Desharnais, and now it's led on for Gallagher. Gallagher stops and waits. Pressured by Quine and then ripped one from a terrible angle, and Gallagher put it off the glass back out to the point. That one hit Letty, bounced in front. Gallagher trying to settle. Greiss the save, the rebound, they score. Put back in by Paul Byron, and the Canadiens have a 1-0 lead.
It was all about Gallagher, his persistent work. Talked about just a bad angle shot, but that's never a bad play to shoot the puck, and that's really what starts the ball rolling for the Montreal Canadiens. It gets the Islanders running around a little bit. Gallagher, as you see here, trying to handle it, gets another shot. Thomas Greiss has the first shot. Travis Hamonic can't get close enough to Byron to prevent that rebound position, and Byron's able to shovel it past Thomas Greiss. You see Greiss has lost his angle just a little bit too far to his left and not able to get back into position. And the Montreal Canadiens strike first, but Gallagher, as he so often does, is such a pest out there and such a worker, creates opportunities, and even with bad angle shots.
Paul Byron, sixth year in the National Hockey League, second season with Montreal, missed part of and most of training camp in the preseason with pneumonia, bounced back, missed one game, made his debut on the 15th of August against Ottawa, and he has scored his second goal of the season as he gets one here tonight, and now a 2-on-1 developing. It's Galchenyuk for Gallagher, and the backhand goes wide on the glove side of Greiss. Gallagher again, Dahan in the way. Clutterbuck came over, knocked it for Chimera. Chimera slips it over well behind Seidenberg. Clutterbuck followed up, slamming right in the skates of Seidenberg. Twisted around nearly to Chimera, and stepping up to make the play was Yemelin. They liked the play of Yemelin so much that they elevated him to play on the top pair with Shea Weber.
He's solid, and he brings a physical presence to the game.
Rajalong to Lehkonen, and there's a shot snatched out of the air by Thomas Greiss, and you can see the Canadiens with a jump at the start here of the second period. It's the seventh game of the season for Montreal. They have now scored first in all seven games, and they're 5-0-1 in the first six.
Canadiens have always been a good team when they have the lead. They just seem to thrive on that ability to jump in the lead. They get energy from it, particularly at home. The fans really get involved in the game, and the Canadiens become a very difficult team to play against. They force you into mistakes, get you out of your structured game, and the Islanders will have to continue to work hard and have some patience with their own game.
Byron from Gallagher and Yemelin at 3:10 of the second period, as it is 1-0 Montreal. Lee cut it around Plekanec, and Lee loads it up. Shot it off Petrie. Goes after it there. They come together. Puck off the glass. Beauvillier couldn't reach it. And it's Rajalov up ice. Forced the pass over and got it back. Rajalov to the front. And what a sprawling save from Thomas Greiss on Plekanec. 3-on-2 back up ice for the Islanders. Lee forced it on. Nelson gets back to it, but can't do much with it along the wall there. Hickey with Petrie, Beauvillier, and he'll take care of both of them, will Petrie. And the puck transitioning ahead for Montreal. Radulov's offside as Thomas Greiss keeps it from being a 2-0 Montreal lead.
Islanders really fortunate not to be down a couple of goals. Radulov gets the puck to the outside on a nice little drop pass. And look at Plekanec going towards the net, but a sprawling save. Great read by Thomas Greiss as he sees that pass from Radulov coming across. Plekanec's can't get a one-timer away, has to hesitate just for a second. That gives Thomas Greiss just the little extra time he needed to establish his aggressive self. Comes up with a huge save for the Islanders. Otherwise, they would have been down 2-0.
Hamonic floats it in. Ladd will get there, along with Shea Weber. As those two come together, the puck bounced to the front. And then Ladd cut it off as Deneau tried to find Flynn. Bailey twisted up in his skates, finds it again. Turning is Ladd, can't get the shot on net. Tavares releases, comes to the boards. Tavares to Letty, over for Hamonic. Lots of space, winds and shoots, and that one ramps right up off a stick and off the glass. Tavares will set it up for Hamonic again. Just inside the line, over for Letty. Wrist shot off a skate of Weber, bouncing puck. Cannot be kept in by Nick Letty.
Yeah, so difficult to get the puck towards the net. And little wonder the Montreal Canadian goaltenders have such good save percentages and averages. They just don't have to make a lot of saves. Their defense and forwards get in that shooting lane.
Dropped off by Pacioretty. Desharnais back for Pacioretty. And then it is Andrew Ladd finding it behind the net. Just laid out in front of his own goal. Skated into by Letty, who still has some gas left in the tank at the end of a long shift. He'll dump it in and go to the bench as the puck rims all the way around for Alan Quine. Quine poking at it. Barzal chopped it off the stick of Shaw. And now down low for Strome. Strome and Shaw come together. Squirts free around Al Montoya. And Petrie will hurry it ahead. Pacioretty chipped it by DeHaan. Catches back up to it. Pacioretty's backhand rolling towards the net. Rice came out to stop it. Got tied up with the always aggressive Andrew Shaw. In front again. Pacioretty's shot shut down by a challenging Greiss. And he juggles the rebound off to the corner.
Two good shots from Pacioretty in the slot. And Thomas Greiss, great saves.
This one knocked out by DeHaan. Desharnais gets there first. Spins it around the boards. Coming in from the point, Nathan Beaulieu. Out for Shaw again. Shaw to the front. DeHaan on a knee. Stops it, waits, and then will launch it down. And it'll be a welcomed icing for the Islanders to calm things down after a flurry of activity around Thomas Greiss.
Thomas Greiss, boy, looking very sharp, very aggressive. Being able to establish his position at the top of the crease. Square his shoulders to the shooter. Good pressure by the Montreal Canadiens. There's a little run-in with Shaw. And of course, that's the way Shaw plays, driving towards the net. But Pacioretty, two good chances in the slot area. Thomas Greiss makes saves on both of them.
Here in the second period, 6-1 are the shots for the Canadiens. The Hans pass over in front of the board. That allows the Islanders to get a change, if nothing else, while Gallagher brings it back in across the Islanders' line. Forced to the front, and Byron couldn't direct it on goal. He was looking for his second already. Gallagher's shot off the stick of Greiss finds the glass.
Yeah, Capuano might want to think about a timeout here as his team is really getting outplayed.
Seidenberg, dangerous in front of the net. Galchenyuk to Gallagher. Greiss is there again. Quine can't get it out as play continues for Montreal.
Yeah, some glorious in-close chances as the Canadians are just all over the Islanders.
Flutterbuck without a stick, and that allowed a point-blank shot from Markov and another save to add on to Thomas Greiss's total so far tonight. 1-0 Montreal. Could have been worse if not for Greiss.
Second period, the Canadians lead the Islanders 1-0. If it's not for that man right there, it could be a whole lot more. Shaw bumps into Thomas Greiss. He's supposed to try and avoid the goaltender. Didn't look like he did much of a job in trying to avoid him. Thomas Greiss takes matters in his own hand and says, hey, you're paying attention, I hope, because that guy kind of ran me a little bit. Just want to make you aware of it. Ref says, yeah, I'm paying attention. Don't worry about it. That's referee Chris Lee talking it over to Thomas Greiss. Sometimes you're just planting a seed for the next time. Then he gets a little brush, and the referee says, okay, you know, I gave Shaw the benefit of the doubt last time. Not this time.
Sure, he didn't just come over and say, hey, ref, you see how many nice saves I've made? Check those ones out. Look at the replays on the video board. It's been impressive for Thomas Greiss here. And that's not a good thing for the Islanders, as all of the action has been on the Islanders' side of the ice here since the start of the second period, which is 7 minutes and 38 seconds old.
Well, Islanders have to get their feet moving, and they have to get a little closer together, support one another. They're getting spread out, and they're standing and watching the Montreal Canadiens.
Off the glass, Chimera couldn't find it. Clutterbuck could. Had to go back to Boychuk. Chimera tags up, and that allows a blast in from Boychuk, and it's covered up by Montoya. Just the second shot of the period for the Islanders as Cizikas mixing things up with Petrie in front of the net.
Now you see the Islanders, particularly in their own zone, a lot of times they had the opportunity to carry the puck and they just chipped it out and the Canadians grab it and come right back in. Or around the blue lines, you're trying to make long passes. There's no support. The Canadians are in good position and it has forced you to turn the puck over. So that's what I'm talking about, getting your feet moving and support so you can make short passes and then get into your cycle game or, you know, back and forth between the forwards and the defense, spread that Montreal team out a little bit.
Tavares off the draw, had his stick broken in half as Plekanec came away with that. Tavares did get a new stick from the bench as the puck transitions back into the Islanders and Radulov gloves down a clearing attempt from Greiss. And as Hickey battles with Radulov, the puck forced to the front. Held in by Yemelin. Yemelin's shot redirected away. And it'll allow Tavares to come get it. Smart pass on for Hickey. Hickey had the blue line, but the puck just jumped on him and it came back to Ladd. Sloppy pass there, did get through to Boychuk. Hickey, Tavares into the zone. Left it for Ladd as he gets knocked down. It's a three on one the other way. Radulov has Mitchell across, got it to him, and the puck goes wide.
Islanders again guilty of not skating at the blue line. They had no pace, no speed, and then they just turned the puck over and the Canadians get a three on one. And again, they just didn't make a complete pass. And Islanders were fortunate they're not down on a couple of goals. Very sloppy play by the Islanders at this point in time.
Coming up on the halfway point of the hockey game, there has not been a penalty of any kind yet in this game. As this one skips around the back of Al Montoya, who started the first three games of the season for Montreal with Carey Price out with the flu. And now in their first back-to-back situation, they will play at home tomorrow against Tampa Bay. Montoya gets the start as they try and find that balance that everybody's looking for with that dominant number one goalie of how much can you play him without saying it's too much.
And it's nice when you have your backup goaltender go in and play well and the team wins and gives the coach a lot more leeway to rest the big gun.
They're digging for the puck below the goal line of the Islanders and Beauvillier. With a little help from Lee, can't get it out of the zone. Bjarne all the way across the ice, patter and juggle it, and it came out the center.
Montreal's just able to get to the puck first. Just a little quicker on the puck, a little quicker reacting. Islanders are watching. I call it the RCMP game, where you kind of let the Canadians go first, and then you say, I got my man, and that's just too late.
Skipping puck is taken out of the air, and now Shaw and Hamonic in a little bit of a battle. Hamonic will grab a hold of Andrew Shaw.
It might be what the Islanders need is a little bit more, get a little angry, a little aggravation, even maybe a fight just to kind of change the flow of this game because it's going in the wrong direction right now.
No fights at all this season for the New York Islanders. 9:59 to go. It is 1-0 in the second. Montreal up 1-0 halfway through. It's time for a different look presented by Northwell Health. Look north.
Well, the Islanders have an opportunity to get the puck in deep, but they turn it over to Tavares to Ladd, and there's the turnover. Now it's going to be a three-on-one for the Montreal Canadiens. I talked about making smart decisions. You have no pace. You're going to get caught, so the Islanders get up. That's Deneau on the left-hand side of the rink as they get up the ice. Boychuk's back, and on the far side, that's Mitchell, who can't quite handle the puck. Thomas Greiss was across, but the fact of the matter is the Islanders had no speed coming up to the blue line. If you don't have any speed, you're not going to beat anybody. You got to have patience. Play the puck in deep.
Letty and Hamonic out there with Chimera, Cizikas, and Clutterbuck as Chimera's pass came to Letty, who was up leading the pack there. But as it's blocked away, he'll retreat to his natural spot at the blue line. Meanwhile, Cizikas behind the net. Clutterbuck in front, the pass on the other side of him. And taken out to center by Brendan Gallagher. Leading the Canadians in goals is Gallagher with four as Chimera comes in down the wall and will softly behind the net. Sends Cizikas after it. Chimera comes over to get into it with Galchenyuk. And now Strom off the bench picks it up, helps to DeHaan. DeHaan, wrist shot, hits Cizikas in front. Skips to the board, Seidenberg coming in. He snaps one on net. And a save for Montoya as the Islanders showing a little light. Down low, Petrie trying to escape. Strom shadowing him. Played around the net. Launched ahead for Byron, the lone goal scorer in this game, as DeHaan comes back to claim it for New York. Chased after by Gallagher. He'll turn and go to the bench, allowing DeHaan to force it ahead. eventually to Barzell, and now behind the goal, Montoya. Strom coming after him. Quine read that well, got the puck, but they blow it dead on a hand pass as the Islanders touched it down low after being knocked out of the air by Quine.
Islanders getting a little bit more done when making sure they get the puck in deep and then trying to get a little puck retrieval going and create some offensive opportunity, create some ozone time as they spent most of this first 10 minutes in their own zone trying to defend. Thomas Greiss has been under siege and been nothing short of spectacular keeping the Islanders involved in this game. And Jack Campagnano, looking down at his player list, is maybe thinking about shuffling the lines because they're not getting a whole lot done with this revolution.
Well, with the injury to Kuhlman, it has affected not just the line that Kuhlman was on, but three out of the four lines are different. As Shaw closing in, Price got there. Rang up off the mask and then spun around the boards and back out to center, and a sigh of relief for the Islanders.
A lot of good chances, and the Canadians continue to use their speed to get themselves in position for some glorious scoring opportunities.
Kicked around the wall, Seidenberg ties up with Pacioretty. DeHaan wrestling with Shaw, but it's Pacioretty. Found some room. Weber winds and fires. It hit a man in front. Greiss didn't have to stop that one. Yemelin knocks it down. He is knocked down by Quine, and here's Bailey up ahead. Still managed to get four guys back to the Canadiens while the Islanders went to the bench.
The Islanders just haven't been able to sustain any kind of offensive rush. Canadiens have done a real good job on the back check. They haven't got cut off the ice.
Here's Tavares stepping out, looking, shooting. Blocked away, and then Bailey with a good body work got the puck but couldn't do anything with it. Pacioretty took it away. David Desharnais rolls it softly in while the Habs go for a change. It is Hickey off the stick of Greiss. Boychuk to Tavares. Tried to collect that one with his skates, had to stop for it, and then his pass intended for Beauvillier was cut off. Still goes in deep. Ladd pressuring up the wall, and Boychuk had stepped up, and the Islanders did a good job to hold it in. Otherwise, they were giving up an odd man rush the other way with Boychuk pinched in. Pattern connects with Plekanec. Left for Lehkonen. Plekanec after it. Boychuk got there instead. Beauvillier saucered one on the backhand, got it out to center. Hickey exchanging a shove at center ice with Arturi Lehkonen. Lee takes a bump. Got the puck out of the zone, but it's right back onto the stick of Montreal Canadiens. Beaulieu will lift it in. Letty is after it. He and Mitchell tie up. Brock Nelson comes to get the puck. 6:40 to go here in the second period. 1-0. Montreal leads it on a Byron goal. Back 3:10 into this one. It was a stalemate in the first period. The second has belonged to Montreal. Boychuk runs his man Dano off into the boards. Mitchell still with a little bit of space, plays it to the boards. Petrie, right point off the back wall, nearly bounced into the crease, but an alert Thomas Greiss was there for the cover.
And Montreal's been able to use those particular plays with regularity in the second period. They've just outskated the Islanders, been able to get to the corners, pick up the puck, and then get it back to the defense. That creates time and space for the forwards to go to the net and look for deflections or look for rebounds. And Thomas Greiss has had to be unbelievably sharp. You haven't seen the Islanders been able to reciprocate in any way, shape, or form. They've spent most of this period in their own end. And when they have got down to the offensive zone, they haven't been able to get the puck back and throw it to their points or use another forward. It's been a much better defensive game in the defensive zone for the Canadiens. End of the day, it's all about pace, and the Islanders are not playing at the same pace as the Montreal Canadiens.
Shots are 11-2 for Montreal here in the period, 16-10 overall in the hockey game, as Clutterbuck to Chimera, and Chimera able to get it in, but lost it immediately upon entry.
Now there's another turnover.
Gallagher working in, and Hamonic did get a piece of it, and then Hamonic got taken down by Brendan Gallagher, and then a shove from Byron. And it is Hamonic again trying to mix things up and maybe spark this team who has fallen asleep and behind here in the second period. 1-0, Canadian lead at 5:49 to go in the second.
Welcome back to Brooklyn here here in the second period. The Habs up 1-0 on the Islanders. Rick DiPietro and I will be joining you in the Chevrolet intermission report. And Rick, you talked about it after the first period, that a defenseman like Nick Leddy sliding can really be a goaltender's best friend. Well, it was the flip side in the first half of this period, with Thomas Greiss having the upper hand and really helping some of his defensemen out.
Well, Thomas Greiss looked sharp in the first period than you saw in the first half of this period. This game could and should be over. Montreal Canadiens with a couple great opportunities, and Thomas Greiss was up for the task.
Well, we're going to take a look at some of those big saves and more coming up in the Chevrolet intermission report. We'll also have an Islanders player interview, all that and more, but still 5:49 to play here in the second, guys.
Thanks, Shen. Islanders hanging around with the Canadiens here, the last team in the National Hockey League without a regulation loss. 5-0-1 to start the season. We're starting to see a little bit of how they got that far, even without Carey Price in their net.
An awful lot of offense on display by the Montreal Canadiens. Only the great goaltending of Thomas Greiss has allowed the Islanders to stay involved.
Yamalin's drive ricocheted away from Greiss.
Just see how many.
We've got a penalty here for the first time as the stick came up and caught Brock Nelson. And the Islanders will have a power play.
Well, that could be a real break for the Islanders. Maybe a momentum swing, because it's really the pendulum's been swinging in just one direction as the Montreal Canadiens have been the faster group. So perhaps a power play, which has not been very good. They've worked on it the last couple of days. Went with some different looks, can possibly get the Islanders on the score sheet and really get them back on their toes, because they've been on their heels this period.
This Islanders power play is brought to you by Volkswagen. The Islanders power play is just 1-for-15 to start the season. That's 6.7%, tied with Ottawa for the lowest success rate so far in the National Hockey League. Kept in by Strome. We'll see if that becomes a big part of this power play. As the puck kicked around, and Mitchell will lead it ahead, and a shorthanded chance to skate up ice for Danault. Danault trying to power his way through, and he got a shot on goal, and Greiss was there to shut it down. Islanders back ahead. Tavares has Bailey with him. They leave it for Ladd. Ladd has Leddy, goes down low instead for Tavares. Leddy at the top will move to the middle of the ice and fire one into traffic. Knocked down. Tavares scores! It's a power.
It's a great entry for the Islanders, as they're able to get across the blue line with control, and then with a good quick puck movement, Ladd first to Tavares, and then Tavares over to Leddy, and Leddy doesn't hesitate at all. He gets the shot on net, and that's something that the Islanders need to do. You can see Tavares, the quick drop off right away to Ladd, who gives it back to Tavares, out to Leddy at the point, and then Ladd goes in front of the net for the screen, the shot. Montoya's not able to pick it up. Good hard work. Second effort by Ladd, who creates the opportunity for John Tavares. And look at that shot. Good screenshot. Montoya can't see it. Gets beat on the short side. And the Islanders get a badly needed power play goal. But more importantly, let's see if they can generate a little momentum, because it's been all about the Canadiens.
That's the 211th goal in the career of John Tavares. And with that goal, he has tied Derek King for ninth all-time on the Islanders' goal list. It's a power play goal that evens the score and ignites the Islanders as Chimera put it on target. A glove save made by Al Montoya. A little contact there with Casey Cizikas.
Two good shifts in a row now. One was the power play, but that one there, as we've so often seen as we look at that board, John Tavares, he'll continue to climb up the board. He's not about to stop scoring goals. But the Islanders go back with Casey Cizikas' line, as Cappy so often does, the confidence, the trust that he has in Casey Cizikas' line. And they go and get another offensive opportunity, a drive towards the net, and another offensive faceoff. So perhaps the momentum is swinging in the proper direction for the Islander fans.
Andrew Ladd made the play to get the puck from Yamalin, although he didn't touch it. So he doesn't get an assist on it. Nobody does. It's an unassisted goal for John Tavares.
How can that be an unassisted goal? It was a shot by Leddy. It was a save. They'll switch that over. It'll be both a Ladd and a Tavares. Or Ladd and Leddy assist before it's all said and done. I'm going to take a job as a scorekeeper.
There you go. By what they have ruled, they're saying that Yamalin possessed the puck, and that the only person after that to touch it was John Tavares. So we'll see how they rule. This one up in the air and swung at by Barzal way over his head, but he did not make contact. It was touched by the Canadiens next anyway, and now it's Radulov having that one jump off his stick. Big body of Alexander Radulov. Not only did he win three MVPs playing in the KHL, he won three straight MVPs playing in the KHL in Russia.
You can see that he has a lot of talent.
And here he comes to the front of the net. A little dance, and his shot never came through as Seidenberg got back. And so did Josh Bailey to stop him from pulling the trigger.
Well, as so often, I believe he got married and has a young child, and a lot of times that changes everybody's outlook in life.
3-on-2, Tavares will cross the line. Over for Bailey, and the back check by Galchenyuk breaks it up. Ahead now for Gallagher. Into the skates of Byron, offside here as Galchenyuk crossed the line.
Good change by the Montreal Canadiens and good hustle by Galchenyuk to come back hard. His skating is much improved and he understands the defensive part of the game and how important it is. And that's exactly what his coach is expecting him on a regular basis. And he's obviously seeming to get better and better, as is that man there, 91. Great challenge for Galchenyuk to play against a elite centerman. Something the coach will keep his eye on to see how he fares.
Shea Weber rims it around the boards. Bailey tried to touch it to Hamonic. Instead, it's back behind the Islanders' net. Letty and Gallagher get into it there. Holds on long enough for Tavares to get the puck turned over in front. Gallagher's backhand altered by Letty at the last moment. And Hamonic all over Galchenyuk. Got it to Bailey. Bailey to Ladd. Went between his stick and his skates. He catches back up to it. Lobs it in. Tavares after it. Yemelin there. Ladd comes over. Swung it to the top and just a little bit out of the reach of Hamonic. And he'll have to collect it. Fire back around.
Islanders have done that a lot with their passing. They're just a little off.
Ladd put it behind the net. Allowed Beauvillier to try and work for it. Comes to Boychuk at the line, and his shot redirected by Brock Nelson. Hickey had closed in. Beauvillier there as well. Hickey will back off as this one launched towards the goal line. Not the right angle, though, and so there is no icing against Montreal. 2:16 to go here in the second. Amazingly, a 1-1 score. Shots are 17-12 overall in the game, favoring Montreal, who had the early jump and dominated the early stages of this second period. But the power play goal from John Tavares erased all of that. Beaulieu. And there's a shot by Patterin and a big block by Beauvillier, and he is hobbled. Has yet to get back up.
Right on the kneecap, it looked like to me. And obviously in some pain, numbness. A lot of times, as I've said before, you have initial pain, it's a stinger, and you feel like you can't move, and then once you're able to kind of get up on your feet and get that circulation going a little bit, all is well. We'll have to wait and see. Let's hope that it is nothing serious, and that's exactly what it is, as I described. One could hope. You can see as he goes down and blocks the shot. He was in good position, too. I mean, he's up close, which is where you want. You can see him coming out knowing full well he's going to have to block it, turns that right knee down, as I said, hits it right on the kneecap, and that smarts.
And he is gliding off towards the dressing room with just a minute 48 seconds to go in the period, so we'll take that into account.
Yeah, they'll have the training staff or the doctors take a little look at him, make sure there's nothing serious, and it's just more like, as I said, a little bit of a stinger. He's being helped off the ice. It isn't easy blocking shots because you know there's a good chance that you can get hurt or it's going to hurt. So it's a part of the game, and especially a part of today's game where everybody blocks shots.
And every D-man can hammer it. And Greg Patterin put a pretty good charge into that puck that found its way to the knee of Anthony Beauvillier as Andrew Shaw takes a run at Thomas Hickey. And as those two collide once again, Casey Cizikas looking for an escape route. As he shut down, put it to Johnny Boychuk. Root is off the glass and kept in, they say, by Pacioretty. And here is Pacioretty down low. Coming to get him is Hickey. Rolled out to the line, and that shot deflected by Boychuk as Petrie let it go. Again to the front of the goal, and this will allow Clutterbuck to skate ahead. To center, Clutterbuck cuts back and looks, dumps it in off a skate. Rolling puck, Clutterbuck after it himself. Knocked away by Markov, and then Markov will get it back. DeHaan jumping up on a loose puck. Spun to the goal, Montoya there, as we hit the final minute of play in the second period. Tavares worked it on for Bailey. Bailey all the way around the boards. Tavares waiting for it. lets it go through for Seidenberg. Seidenberg crushed against the boards. Play carries on. Puck in the skates of Big Dennis Seidenberg as he kicks it deep. Off along the boards, Darnay didn't get a lot on it. Shaw will backhand this one in the air in front of the Canadiens bench. Bailey to go grab it with a half a minute to work with.
Islanders seemingly working harder now than they did earlier on. It just seems like they have a little more jump to their game.
Softly into the Islanders' end. 20 seconds to go as Seidenberg to Tavares and Bailey. All the way over for DeHaan. DeHaan winds, fires. Montoya has it right in front of him as he babysat it and then covered it up. And a whistle with 10.3 on the clock.
DeHaan very much aware that the clock was winding down, wanted to keep the puck in front of him. And thought best to shoot it right at Montoya. And good news for the Islanders there. They get an offensive faceoff with about 10 seconds to go. So that's not a bad thing. You know, if he misses the net, Brendan, and then, you know, then maybe he has to defend. So DeHaan makes the good play, forces Montoya to make a save.
You mentioned he was aware. It looked like he actually glanced up to check and see exactly how much time was left before he wound up to hammer that one in. Strome has Nelson set up as the trigger man off the faceoff. Tried to get it to him and just a little bit away from him. Hamonic can't keep control of it. Plekanec from the red line in the final seconds will loft it in. Grice will just lay it off into the corner. And the second period comes to a close, a period in which Thomas Grice was the best player on the ice, and a timely power play goal from John Tavares, and we're all even headed to the third.
Nothing more I can say on that, Udo. You capped it off rather well, other than, you know, obviously the Islanders have to find that mojo in the coming into the third period. Their goaltender saved them. They started the play a little bit better, as I mentioned, a little more jump as the period came to an end, and that goal certainly was a big boost to their morale, their confidence, and it lightened the load holders. So let's see if the Islanders can put 20 strong minutes together, win a hockey game.
Stay tuned for the second period intermission report presented by Chevrolet. John Tavares will be with Shannon. Rick DiPietro will break down the period and the great play from Thomas Grice during the frame. 1-1 after two in Brooklyn.
Andrei Markov, 16th season, 935 games. Well, that just tells you right there how long it's been since the Montreal Canadiens have won a Stanley Cup. This is a franchise that's used to winning Stanley Cups, but Andrei Markov, who's a terrific player, just hasn't been in the right era, I guess, or he's still hoping.
Played all 82 games last year at age 37 for Montreal. In his 15th season, all with the Canadiens. 1-1 score here at the start of the third. We'll see if the Islanders can assert themselves here, much like the way the Canadiens did at the start of the second period, but an icing call won't help that cause, and quickly Shelterian is taking advantage of an opportunity to make last change, which you don't normally get on the road, but here 24 seconds into the period, after an icing, he will.
With that new rule, you have those opportunities every once in a while. Just one side note with Markov, he's a free agent at the end of this season, so we'll see if he signs another term with the Montreal Canadiens, or maybe he wins a cup and he could retire.
Right off into the sunset. Puck comes to Jason Chimera, and good reach there by Markov. Knocked it off Chimera's stick with the wheels that he has. If he could have taken off one-on-one, you never know where that's going to end. As Seidenberg steps into a pass, gets to center, dumps it in, goes for a change.
Well, you would expect the Islanders to play a little bit more of a conservative game or a little smarter game. Getting the puck in deeper and playing a little chip and chase, or a little better forechecking.
We heard John Tavares tell Shannon during the intermission about how disappointed he was and the team was with their performance during the frame, as an icing is beaten out here by Pacioretty. You can imagine some of those sentiments were shared in the dressing room, not only with Shannon during the break, as Yemelin shot, tip, save, rebound, and Grice got enough of it to force it away to the corner.
First one was a positional save. He just squared himself to the shooter, which was Weber, and was able to make the first save on that screenshot.
Bear is pulled down by Shea Weber, and now up the ice. It is Brian Flynn charging down the wall. Flynn's shot blockered through the slot, comes out for Yemelin. Yemelin's shot sailed high as Grice watched it go by, and this one will kick all the way down the ice. Al Montoya out to play. Getting a piece is Beauvillier. Playing with Nelson and Lee as Mitchell connects with Flynn, nearly ran right into Dano. And now Dano gloves it down, but Beauvillier in the way. Mitchell gets tangled up and hits the ice. Hickey behind the net.
Great puck receipt by the Montreal Canadiens. That's what's causing the Islanders an awful lot of problems.
Here's Brock Nelson to the outside. Forced one through. Boychuk joining the play. And the defenseman down low. Has goals in back-to-back games as Beauvillier now off the ice, and Ryan Strome getting a shift here. Twisted down low and it rolls through Greg Patterson. Rest of that change is completed as Quine goes in. Now Strome knocks a Beaulieu pass out of the air. Puck is over, skated by Byron, comes back for it. The speedy winger drops it off for Galchenyuk. Across into the right circle, that one redirected wide. Picked up by Strome, he'll force this one out. And that center, Beaulieu gloves it down. A couple of touches later and it's Galchenyuk in across the line.
Islanders have to do a better job in the neutral zone. The Canadians are able to approach the blue line with great speed.
Markov slipped one wide of the net, and this one came through to the front. Byron may have gotten a piece of that shot on its way to Greiss, but he knocks it down, covers it up, and stops the clock. 17:11 to go here in the third period.
Well, you're watching the Montreal Canadiens, and they have so much speed coming through the neutral zone. They're able to back the defense off, and then they can go to work with delay tactics and then chipping it into the corner and then getting to the puck first and using their point. So their structure has been very, very good, but the Islanders have to do a much better job of closing their gap, putting more pressure on in the neutral zone and not allowing them to generate that speed. Worst case scenario, force them to dump it in from the center ice zone.
Flutterbuck can't work it past Beaulieu. On the layoff side, too high. And now a race for the puck as DeHaan comes in, punches it down low for Chimera. Tangled up, a little grabbing going on with Buchanan. Her play carries on as Flutterbuck finishes his check on Arturi Lehtinen.
Much better shift for the Islanders, forcing the Montreal Canadiens to play along the boards. The Islanders had good jump, physical, had some ozone time. Need a few shifts, put a few shifts together like that.
Bailey able to take it away from Torrey Mitchell. Tavares and Ladd after it. Ladd finishes his check. The puck comes ahead for the Canadiens anyway. Mitchell hands it off. Flynn cruises in. Flynn makes his way towards the boards, drags it between the legs of his teammate, runs into Bailey. Bailey took it away, and this is John Tavares. Across the ice, Ladd wanted to return it to Tavares, instead sent it behind the net. Yemelin maneuvers away from Tavares, but ran it right up the back of the referee. And at the red line, Lenny trying to keep it from crossing into the Islanders' end, and does. Ladd for Hamonic. Hamonic whiffed on a pass, second effort, picked up by Desharnais. Desharnais down the wall, threw it through the blue paint, and it steered all the way to the boards. Beauvillier was in the vicinity. Centering feed intended for Beaulieu. Shaw cut it off instead, and that'll help out the Islanders. Beaulieu is sliding in from the point, and instead of coming through for him, it was cut off halfway there. Patch ready for Shea Weber. Wants to shoot it, and he has some space now. Wrist shot this time. Hit his old man Shaw in the back, and a sprawling save by Thomas Greiss keeps it tied. Add another one to the impressive display by Greiss.
Looked like Beaulieu had a wide open net, tried to go low with it. Thomas Greiss shot that right pad off and caught it, I believe, just with his skate. Beaulieu needed to get it up high, chose to go low with it. And the Canadiens were denied once again by Thomas Greiss.
Lee all the way over for Beauvillier, out of his reach. Nelson now just left it along the boards. Nobody could get to it in a blue sweater. Instead, it's Gallagher throwing it around the ledge of the boards. Quinn and Boyd juggle. And as this one bounces free, Hickey right back out of the zone. Long shift here for Beauvillier. He's going to take a chance and go to the bench for a change. Meanwhile, the Habs come back in. Deflected shot, and Beaulieu is tied up by Boychuk.
Boychuk stayed right with him, didn't take a penalty. Canadiens again have real good jump.
Turning is Galchenyuk off the crossbar, and Greiss got the rebound from Gallagher. Oh boy, and the Islanders escape again. Back the other way is Quine. Quine able to hold it in. Beaulieu gloves it down and leads it ahead. Gallagher at center, taken by DeHaan, as the Islanders desperate to try and calm things down. Barzal to the slot. DeHaan with the blast, the glove, the cover from Montoya.
Exciting hockey, a lot of offensive opportunities, and Thomas Greiss using that post keeps the score at 1-1. Third period, the Canadians and the Islanders are tied 1-1. Well, that guy's almost been tied up in knots several occasions. Beaulieu with a rebound, but it's Travis Hamonic of a good position who blocks that shot, helping his goaltender out. And then Galchenyuk, turn around, spin around, a quick release off the crossbars. Thomas Greiss tried to fight that one, but used his trusty goal post. He would tell you it's the perfect angle. I knew how far out I needed to be. But again, it's the Montreal Canadiens with a push, much like we saw in the second period until the Islanders were able to score that power play goal. They got the Islanders again on their heels.
Galchenyuk hit the crossbar and then a post, and there's a tip shot that Montoya stopped, maybe inadvertently.
One of the few times the Islanders were able to get a shot from the point. And that's been really the difference, is the availability for the Canadiens to get the puck and then get it back to their defense, and then everybody crashes the net looking for rebounds and deflections.
When Shea Weber's out there and the puck comes his direction, everybody has to flinch. And he's out there right now. Playing with Yemelin. Flynn gets there and Zizekas gets him. But the puck stopped right at the line by DeHaan. Didn't quite get it deep. Played across the ice. And from center, Flynn will get it deep. 12 minutes and 50 seconds to go. Third period, 1-1. Byron at 3:10 of the second. Tavares on the power play at 15:17. That's your score. Unassisted was Tavares' goal. And here's Tavares, who may need an unassisted effort here. Opens up and waits. He shoots, and it's saved by Montoya. Be all for Islanders this season at Barclays Center. See the Isles take on the Toronto Maple Leafs on Sunday, October 30th, where trick-or-treat bags will be available for the first 3,000 fans age 13 and under on the main concourse. Call 800-745-3000 or visit islanders.nhl.com to secure your seats today.
All of Andy Martin fans, they'll get a chance to see him when the Maple Leafs get here. And another important note is young Anthony Beauvillier playing with Bailey and Tavares. So Jack Capuano trying to shake things up, because obviously it's not going like he'd like it to go. They're getting outplayed and out-hustled.
Beauvillier will go in and apply some pressure on Petrie as Markov works it away from Bailey. We'll see what that does to the other lines. It was Beauvillier playing with Lee and Nelson at the start of this hockey game. As Andrew Ladd's spot now belongs to Beauvillier for the moment. The 19-year-old drops it back off, and Letty had one sailed wide. Hamonic quickly in front, tip save, rebound Tavares, tried to poke it to Beauvillier, but he had left to go get it as Tavares took a shot up high from Markov. Referee right there watching it all unfold. No penalty on the play. There's only been one penalty in the game, and the Islanders scored a power play goal on it.
It was kind of a little bit no harm, no foul, as both guys were going at one another. Tavares knocked Markov down in front of them earlier on.
Patterns blast held on to by Grice. Hamonic is right there to make sure Pacioretty gets no closer.
Well, I call it the dirty area. It's also the very tough area, and you have to deal with on occasions as Markov and Tavares go at a little hold right there. Now there's a push, maybe a little dive. Watch the two of them go at it. Markov coming back at him. A little pushing and shoving. Well, that's the tough way to earn a living, but Tavares knows all about it. Markov knows all about it. He's been doing it a long time, and nothing will change as this game goes on. That's the one-on-one battles that you got to deal with and survive.
This one off into the corner and picked up by Hickey. The line is Nelson centering Lee and Ryan Strom as Beaulieu's pass was overskated here. Strom the other way. Strom looked like he got a little tug on the hands there, but play carries on.
This was the kid line that was so good last year early on in the season.
Lee to the front. Nelson can't sneak it through. Loose puck at the side of the net, I would imagine, as they let it play out without blowing the whistle, and now chaos behind the goal line.
Now there's starting to be a little energy, a little emotion in the game as both teams are shoving and pushing, and now the game is starting to get on the line. So the anger meter goes up a little bit, but at the end of the day, it was Nelson who had a pretty good opportunity, is that what I call him, the kid line, with some good cycling, some good puck movement, get into the holes, get some shots on. There's the quick shot, almost beats Montoya down low. And then, of course, the pushing and the shouting, and, you know, introducing themselves. They haven't seen each other since last year, so, you know, how'd it go last summer? What did you do? I'll tell you, I worked hard, but look at that nice setup. Great pass. Brock Nelson gets a real good look at it. So that was a good give and go and moving into the holes and receiving the passes, and something the Islanders haven't been able to do a whole lot of in tonight's game. The Islanders are still tied at 1-1, even though they've been outplayed at times quite dramatically.
Barzal playing between Chimera and Alan Quine here, as in the third period, Jack Capuano has thrown the lines into the blender and come up with a whole new combination.
Well, he really had to, and it's a good play on his part because his team just was not able to really competing all that well with the Canadians, and now they just seem to have a little jump, and sometimes that's what happens. You just sort of change the mind frame of the players.
Just the second NHL game for Matthew Barzal as he swings it in and goes to the bench as it's stopped behind by Montoya. As Cizikas right off the bench popped the puck in the air, but as it lands for Weber, he'll lift it ahead. It is Andrew Ladd playing with the Cizikas and Clutterbuck duo.
Reinders now. See what happens there. Perhaps that's what Andrew Ladd might need to score a goal, get into the grinder mode.
This puck coming through, Gallagher got too much of it. Kept him at the top by Petrie. And here is DeHaan, 4-on-2 as he joins the play. Clutterbuck to Cizikas, back to Clutterbuck, looking over, trying to sneak it short side. And on that post was Montoya. Clutterbuck went to go to the point, realized at the last moment there was nobody on that side. Tried to hold up, puck still came to center. And the Islanders will have to regroup in their own end. 9:40, 3 to go, third period. Game tied at 1. Ladd to Cizikas, can't cut to the front of the goal. Shaking ahead, and it's Arturi Lehkonen. Matched up with Hamonic. Letty comes over. Stops to get away from Radulov. Letty, a little space here as he cruises into the offensive zone. Stops and looks to the slot. Tavares on goal. Save and a cover from Al Montoya.
A much better pace for the Islanders. They've got the Canadians backing up now. So for now, the juggling of the lines has done well.
Back and forth we go.
Montoya's given up one goal. Thomas Greiss has given up one goal, but the Islanders are pressing. Clutterbuck from the outside. Montoya, normally you see goaltenders go down on that butterfly. Not for Montoya, just hugs the post and stays up. The Islanders come right back. Letty leading the rush. John Tavares quickly into the slot with a good wrist shot. Tremendous positioning by Montoya out at the top of the circle. A good clear look at it. But a lot more offense from the Islanders over the last little while. Much needed offense pushing back on the Montreal Canadiens.
Shots in the third period, 6 apiece. Overall in the game, 23-19 for Montreal's Boychuk from the line. And Montoya was looking behind him.
Looked like he wanted to just kind of knock that to the corner. Maybe got there just a little bit early, not perfect timing, but was able to make that save. Good face-off win by the Islanders, and that allows Johnny Boychuk to get that quick one-timer. Islanders, not enough time to get in front of the net, though.
Bailey to the top for Boychuk. That one fluttered towards the goal, and he'll hang on to this one again. If there's one thing to pick out about this Canadiens team, which has been so good in the first 6 games of the season, they've been subpar in the faceoff department. You see the Islanders capitalizing on a little bit of that, winning back-to-back draws and getting shots to the goal.
Islanders were much better in the third period. They weren't very good in the first 2 periods. John had lost a third of his. Galchenyuk for the Canadiens has been real poor, and he's been a sore spot for the Montreal Canadiens on faceoffs. Mechanics has always been very, very good.
This draw, won by Barzal. Boychuk, why not? Deflected nearly through the legs. Weber and then to Montoya, and it stays out.
Islanders doing a real nice job. Cizikas wins that particular faceoff, and there's such an advantage now, generally speaking, for the offensive centerman because you can cheat a whole lot, and that's what the NHL wanted, was a lot more offense created. And that one bounces off pattern and almost into the net. Montoya had to react quickly to keep that one out of his net.
Chimera grinding it out down low. Trying to go across for Quine. Instead, he needs the Canadians the other way. Boychuk with Mitchell all over him, trying to get away. It's Mitchell instead. Backhand wraparound try. Greiss was there. Weber's shot trickling through off the post and in. Montreal has the lead with 8:39 to go.
And it's just a simple play by the Montreal Canadiens. It's a chip and chase play as Mitchell gets the puck deep, forces the turnover down low, or I should say the puck retrieval down low. Montreal Canadiens just go to work. Weber just gets a shot on net. Talked about him. He's got a boomer, but he just gets the quick release. There's the work down low by Mitchell. Tries to jam it in. The Islanders clear it right back to Weber. Quick release, wrist shot, and Danault is right in the perfect spot, able to chip it in. You can see his sticks down on the ice, and Danault gets a fortuitous bounce. He's able to play it off the post, and the Canadiens have taken the lead again.
Second of the season for Danault. And the Islanders, who have never had a lead in this game, now trail with 8.5 minutes remaining in the third period. Puck in the offensive end for New York, and Seidenberg trying to keep it there. It's tangled up with Pacioretty. Strome digging at it. Comes to Nelson. Nelson's backhand, gloved by Pacioretty, lofted ahead, intended for Shaw, went too far, and DeHaan to retrieve. Seidenberg around the wall, tries to one-hand it ahead. Came off of Strome. Didn't clear the zone. Comes to DeHaan. He struggles with it. Ultimately forces it on for Strome. And then his pass was behind Nelson. Islanders will get a change with what they can, as Markov hangs out behind the net. Long pass. Lekkonen had to wait for it. He got hit by Hamonic. Play carries on. Lekkonen gets back to it. And that one's shrugged off by Grice. Meanwhile, Letty shaking up on that play, as he'll get back to his feet as Clutterbuck carries it. Clutterbuck to the front, and it bounced off of Ladd as he was wrapped up with Greg Patterin. Clutterbuck's drive stopped by Patterin's skate, pulling away from Cizikas. Lekkonen leads it out. Right back in from Clutterbuck. Montoya out to stop it. Al Montoya brought in as a backup, as an insurance policy for Carey Price. And so far, he has put up Carey Price-like numbers in the first 3-plus games of the season. He has allowed just one goal on 22 Islanders shots tonight. And the former Islander already 3-0 against his former team.
A lot of goaltenders, as they get to be in that 30 range, that's when they hit their full potential. And Montoya has been a learner all the way along. Always had a lot of skill, and sometimes it just takes you a little longer than everybody else.
They gave assists on that goal from Danault to Weber and Mitchell. So another point for Shea Weber. His 8th point and 6th assist of the season, as Beauvillier's shot glanced off of Montoya. Tries to track down his own rebound, but lost track. Then Boychuk wristed one. Loose puck in the crease, bouncing around. Backhanded wide by Beauvillier, as he had a lot of net to look at.
Well, he had a little more time than he thought he did. He thought he had to react quickly, and he'll be upset with himself. Needed to show just a little bit more poise with the puck, and that'll come with a little more experience. But a good rally by the Islanders. Shane Weber with another plus, league leading.
Plus 10 coming into the game here today. And that highly scrutinized trade with Nashville.
Plus 2 on this game.
And it's looked pretty good so far for Montreal. One of those trades, it's probably going to work out for both teams. Seidenberg shoots and scores! It's a tie game again! And it's the defense again, as Seidenberg wired one past Montoya.
Well, it was good forechecking by the Islanders. They've got to work in this third period where they've been much better controlling the corners, getting the puck retrievals, and then using their points. Talked about the Montreal Canadiens doing that very effectively through most of the game. Well, it's the Islanders now that are able to get in deep, find the puck. And we'll see Beauvillier with an excellent opportunity where he has time, and he just rushes it, goes off the end of his stick. You can see his reaction. You go, can you believe this? But what a beautiful pass across the Seidenberg, and that puck has eyes. It goes by everybody in the far corner. And the defense has done it again for the Islanders on a bit of a knuckleball. Beautiful screen in front by Lee. No way for Montoya to see it. He's just standing there and saying, I hope it hits me. He's spreading out, trying to be as big as a house. But he's not. He's only the size of a tent. And it gets right by him. And the Islanders, Seidenberg has scored. And the Islanders are back at a tie. But good hard work by the Islanders down low before that to create the opportunity.
This one ricochets back into the Islanders' zone. Seidenberg will go get it. The 35-year-old German closing in on 800 career National Hockey League games. Bought out from Boston over the summer. And what an impact he has made as Ezekis drags and shoots, but it's blocked. Seidenberg is there again. Came into the World Cup of Hockey in Toronto without a contract, left with a deal with the New York Islanders. And here he is again with the puck along the boards. Calvin DeHaan gets the primary assist, but it's given up here, and here's Sean, a breakaway, trying to break a 2-2 tie, and he missed the net on the close side of Greiss.
Islanders too cute at the blue line. Can't get carried away with the fact they just tied the game up and can get another one right away. They've got to keep that puck down low. No turnovers, and he turned it over a couple of times now at the blue line.
Andrew Ladd did get the secondary assist on that goal from Seidenberg, so now two assists on the season for Andrew Ladd here in his seventh game. Up to the line, Petrie shot, and that one didn't miss by much. Kicks around, and it's Markov.
Petrie has a very good shot also from the point, former Edmonton Oiler.
Behind the goal line, Tavares and Radulov dueling for it. Tavares trying to work it free. Into the circle, there's a quick shot that knuckled towards the goal and punched aside by Thomas Greiss. Markov leads it on, but Hamonic is there for New York, and now Letty into the zone. Beauvillier took an extra moment. Bailey had a streaking Tavares, but it was shut down by Markov. Back the other way, Gallagher fakes a shot, then takes a shot. Boychuk got enough of it, put it away. Gallagher alone to the front, and he's knocked down. Greiss the save. It'll poke the rebound away. It'll be a penalty against the Islanders. The first of the hockey game with 3 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the third. Tied up at two, thanks to Seidenberg. The keys to the game are brought to you by GMC. See the pros at your local GMC dealer. We are professional grade. Seidenberg with a game-tying goal at 14:16 to the third period. Tavares scores again. And the two Montreal goals from Byron in the second period. Dano here in the third. And a penalty called, a slashing call against Nick Leddy will put the Islanders' impeccable penalty kill to the test here with 3:50 to go.
Yeah, that's a good slash there on the Montreal Canadian, and an excellent chance to score. And that was Plekanec, so it looked like he was going to tap the puck into an empty net.
And that slash didn't even stop the scoring chance. Followed up Beaulieu, got one through, made Greiss make another save. The Islanders' penalty kill, the best in the league to start the season, 21 of 22 at 95.5%. This is the first penalty of the game of any kind called against the Islanders. There's only been one against Montreal as Quarterback will lift it down. And already, good chunk of time wasted. We've hit half a minute off the board. Shea Weber. Pacioretty, Shaw, Desharnais, and Beaulieu out there for Montreal. At the blue line. Down low. And Petrie for Weber. One-timer, and he scores. Shea Weber let it go and sneaks inside the post. And a power play goal with 2:57 left gives the Canadians a 3-2 lead.
One of the hardest shots in the National Hockey League, Shea Weber. Very efficient individual, particularly on the power play when you give him a chance to wind up and let it go. And Thomas Greiss with no chance to get over there as the Canadians knew exactly what they wanted to do, come across, lay it right over on a tee, and that almost goes off the head of Travis Hamonic. I mean, he is real, real deep. There's nothing he can do about it when he's down that low. And the Islanders, I'm not sure they wanted to kill it that way because the positioning for that particular shot just is too much room for Shane Weber, and Travis Hamonic down real, real low and just missed taking that off the noggin.
A goal for Weber. 2:47 after the Islanders had tied it is his third of the season. He's got another multi-point game. And now with 3 goals, 4 assists, 7 points, and a +9 in the past 4 games. Islanders now need another to square things up, and they've only got 2:40 left to do it. Beauvillier in a race with Yemelin. And this one sneaks past Hickey at the line, and Boychuk has to backtrack for it. On now to Bailey. As this one rolls by, Weber chased after by Beauvillier. Nice job by Hickey to keep it in, but that was only a momentary success. Boychuk, he's got a heavy bomb as well. Why not try it from center? Knocked down, and Montoya, a little head fake, and then played it back across his body.
Confident move by Montoya, a little fake to the left, and then pass it over to the right. Carey Price is very good at handing the puck off to his defense. Montoya taking a lesson from his teammate.
Strome left it for Boychuk, who has logged a lot of minutes here tonight. Letty trying to create something here. Minute 46 to go as the whistle sounds and the faceoff is coming outside the zone. Thomas Greisen just started to move. He's, as you can see at the hash marks.
Doug Waite with the chalkboard. Wondering if the Montreal Canadiens are going to call a timeout. They probably won't. They've been able to get a faceoff outside the blue line. And Jack Capuano looks like he's thinking about calling timeout.
And Jack Capuano hasn't called it yet. Called the referee over, who thought he was calling a timeout, and then decides he's going to keep it in his back pocket.
And he's still got a fair bit of time. Some guys like to pull their goaltenders extremely early. He hasn't got Tavares out. He hasn't got all his offensive guns out. So perhaps Tavares was just out. Might want to wait for another 20 seconds.
Shaw will put it deep in the wrong end for the Islanders. As Letty turns it up ice for Lee. Capuano calling for Grice, but the puck has to get deep as Strome bounces it in. Grice is off the ice. Ladd, the extra attacker. Played around the boards, nobody on this side of the ice, and this one lifted down, but Boychuk will get there before it slides by. 1:05 to go. Islanders have responded every time the Canadiens have scored. Can they do it without running out of time? 6-on-5 the attack, and they're struggling to get out of their own end.
They're looking to get some speed generated as they go up the ice. They were all standing still.
Down to 45 seconds to go. Stretch pass on for Beauvillier. The 19-year-old Anthony Beauvillier tripped up, no call. Play continues. Ladd along the boards. Ladd, 33 seconds left. Boychuk resting it, ricochet just wide. Hickey tried to steer it towards the net, and it's deflected behind. Racing after it is Hickey again as he jams it down the wall. Boychuk took a stick up high. That's a penalty that will be called with 20 seconds to go. Boychuk, still down on his knees, will be checked out by the officials.
And if it's a 4-minute penalty, it would be relevant if they do score the Islanders and it goes into overtime. The Islanders would start on a 5-on-3. We'll see what the call is. But the Canadians might have got away with one earlier on. There's the high stick right away to Gallagher. See what the penalty was.
Just a 2-minute minor.
Just a 2-minute minor, but Shea Weber looked like he might have inadvertently tripped Beauvillier on the far side from us. Couldn't tell on the angle, but Beauvillier went down. And now the Islanders will have 20 seconds, and the faceoff will be most important.
Jack Capuano calls timeout. This timeout is brought to you by the Lincoln Motor Company. And Butch, I ask you, what does it say about the faith that he has in Anthony Beauvillier with the amount of ice time he's logging here down by a goal?
Well, he's been, again, one of the better players for the Islanders. He continues to play with jump, and that's been the most important element for the Islanders, is trying to get the guys to play with jump. The Canadians, for the most part, have been the better team. Islanders have had a much better third period. They've been able to create a lot more offense, spend more time in the offensive zone. But the Canadians have been a resilient group, and they've taken advantage of Islander miscues in the defensive zone.
Anthony Beauvillier has taken 20 shifts tonight. Season high, 15 minutes and 57 seconds of ice time. That is significantly higher than any other game that he has had. This Islanders power play is brought to you by Volkswagen. 6-on-4 with an empty net for New York. 20.4 seconds to work with, and Tavares kicks the faceoff back to Letty. Over, Boychuk blasted on goal. Montoya the save. Boychuk keeps it in for the moment. 12 seconds to go. This one steered down the ice. Letty to retrieve it as we hit 8. Into the spread line, now into the offensive end. Letty down the wall, slides it. Ladd couldn't direct it. 2 seconds and one, and the Islanders run out of time to respond to Montreal's final tally. 3-2, the Canadiens win it.
And the Montreal Canadiens, for the most part, were the better team. And although it was a nice push from the Islanders, they really found their legs in the third period and started to play in the offensive zone, started to get up the ice. You can see they had a lot more jump, but for the most part, you know, they didn't have it. And John Tavares said it best. I mean, it was unacceptable after two periods, and you can't play 20 minutes of hockey and expect to win hockey games. And as Rick DiPietro mentioned, you know, Thomas Greiss isn't short of sensational in that second period. They'd have been down 3 or 4 goals.
Islanders had won back-to-back games. That streak is no longer. The Montreal Canadiens remain the last team without a regulation loss. They improved to 6-0-1. The play of the game is brought to you by Buick. Experience the new Buick for yourself at your local Tri-State Buick dealer. And the Buick play of the game winner on the power play from Shea Weber.
Now just a perfectly laid pass, and he just lays right in. You can see all his weight going from the right side to the left side. Thomas Greiss has a chance to take a look at it, but it just gets by him in a hurry. I mean, it's a fastball, 100-plus miles an hour, and it just zipped right by. And one thing Shane Weber can do, and he can do a lot of things, but he can bring the puck hard.
A couple of more points for him, 3 goals and 6 assists on the season. Tomorrow night, the Islanders battle the Penguins at 7 on MSG+. Live coverage starts at 6:30 with Islanders game night. But stay tuned to hear from the Islanders players and coaches on the Islanders post-game show, which is coming up next as Shannon Hogan will join Butch and I, Rick DiPietro. So much to talk about from this one, but the Islanders on the wrong side of a 3-2 score.